Welcome to this quick guide where I'm going to show you how to create a Windows 10 bootable USB flash drive with Rufus. And if you get any value out of this video, please click the like button and subscribe to the channel. But to get started with the guide, if you want to create a Windows 10 bootable USB flash drive with Rufus, the first thing that you're going to need is a blank USB flash drive that's at least 8 gigs in size, or just a flash drive that you don't mind formatting. So you can go ahead and get that, and then you can just plug that into your computer. And once you've done that, you can go ahead and open up the browser on your computer, and then you can do a search on Google for Rufus USB. The best match should be the Rufus webpage, so you can go ahead and click on that to go to the Rufus webpage. And then once you're here, you can just scroll down all the way until you get to the downloads. And I just recommend that you choose this first option, which is the standard Rufus. Once it's downloaded, you can just click on open file, and it's going to launch it. Here you can just click on yes, so it can check for updates. And then it's going to open Rufus on your computer. Now the first thing you'll see here is the device. And if you only have one USB flash drive plugged in, which you should have only one plugged in, you'll see it here listed in the device tab. And you can just go ahead and select that. Make sure the correct one is selected. Now next you'll see the boot selection, which is disk or ISO image. Here you have two options. You can either go and you can do a search on Google for download Windows 10, and you should get the Microsoft webpage to download the Windows 10 ISO file. And you can get it from the official Microsoft webpage, and I've got a separate guide on how to download this. But the point is, you can choose to download this ISO file and then save it on your computer. And if you click on select, you can then select that ISO file and click on open. And it's going to use that ISO file. Or you can click on this little arrow next to the select button. Then you can select download. Then you can click on this download button. Then Rufus will prompt you for what version of Windows you want to download. And here you can also choose Windows 10. You can select that. Then you can click on continue. Then it's going to prompt you which release of Windows 10 you want to download. You should only be able to download the latest release, so you can just select that and then click on continue. Then you can choose the edition, and right here I only have one selection anyway, so it's going to be Home, Pro or Education. And then next you can click on continue. Then you can choose the language that you want to download. For most of us it should be English International or English US. I'm just going to select English US because that's what I normally use. Then you can click on continue, and next you need to select if you want a 64-bit or a 32-bit version of Windows. x86 means 32-bit, and that's 64-bit. So I'm going to stick with 64-bit, and then you have the option to download this using a browser, or you can just click on download, and it's going to prompt you where you want to save that ISO file. You can just give it a name and then click on save, and it's then going to start downloading the Windows 10 ISO file via Rufus to your computer. Now I've already downloaded this, so I'm just going to click on cancel and then click on close. And like I showed you before, I'm just going to use the select option, then click on select, and then choose the Windows 10 ISO file that I downloaded manually. For the image option, you can leave that on standard Windows installation. Now for the partition scheme, you've got two options, which is GPT and MBR. If you have a newer computer, you'll most probably use GPT, which uses a UEFI BIOS. And if you have an older computer where you want to install Windows 2, you'll most probably be using MBR, which uses a legacy BIOS system. Now I'm going to be selecting GPT because most of you will use GPT. But if you find that you create this USB flash drive and you're unable to boot from it, you can always come back and recreate it and then just choose the MBR option. But once you've done that, you can just change this volume label to something like Windows 10, because that's going to be the name of this USB flash drive. And then the rest you can just leave on default. Then you can click on start. You can also customize the installation. I'm just going to select all of these and then click on OK. You'll be prompted if you want to format the flash drive. Just click on yes and click on OK. And then it's going to start creating that Windows 10 bootable USB flash drive. And you can have a look at the status of it down here, and you'll just need to wait for it to finish, which normally takes about 5 minutes. And once Rufus is finished, you'll see the status turn to ready, and then you can go ahead and close it. And now if you go ahead and open up a file explorer window and go to this PC, you should see that flash drive is now called Windows 10 or whatever you renamed it to. And if you double click on that to open the files, you should see all of the files look like this. And you'll also have this setup application file, and you can also use this to upgrade your computer to Windows 10. But if you go ahead and you shut down your computer and you choose this USB flash drive as the boot device, it's going to boot into the Windows 10 installation. And I've got some other guides on my channel showing you how to install Windows 10. And I'll link those on the screen now. But this has been my guide on how to create a bootable USB flash drive with Windows 10 on it using Rufus. And if you got any value out of this video, please give it a like, and I'll talk to you guys soon.